बॉन्ड वाले एंड टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द नेक्स्ट कंटिन्यूशन द नेक्स्ट कंटिन्यूशन टॉपिक एमसीक्यू डिस्कशन ऑफ मिड एग्जामिनेशन वन राइट एमसीक्यू डिस्कशन मल्टीपल ऑब्जेक्टिव डिस्कशन ऑफ यूनिट 1, 2, 3 प्रीवियस क्लास में मैं फर्स्ट यूनिट पॉलीमर केमिस्ट्री में डिस्कस चेसा पॉलीमर केमिस्ट्री తర్వాత ఎలక్ట్రో కెమిస్ట్రీ కరోషన్ కూడా మనం డిస్కస్ చేశామండి థర్డ్ యూనిట్ లోంచి కొన్ని ఆబ్జెక్ట్ చూసిన తర్వాత అగైన్ ఇంకేమైనా గ్యాప్స్ ఉంటే అవి కూడా మనం చూద్దాం సో సీ దిస్ దేర్ ఇస్ ఎ క్వశ్చన్ ఇస్ ఆస్కింగ్ ఇన్ థర్డ్ యూనిట్ ఇస్ కార్బన్ నానో మెటీరియల్స్ పోలరైన్స్ ఆర్ నోన్ టు బి దట్ పోలరైన్స్ ఆర్ ఇన్హెరెంట్లీ నోన్ టు బి దట్ దే ఆర్ నోన్ టు బి సూపర్ కండక్టర్స్ లెట్ మీ టెల్ యు ద రీజన్ When we are taking carbon nanomaterials of the classification, carbon nanomaterials of one dimensional carbon nanowire, two dimensional carbon nanotube, carbon nanotubes of two classification, single valved carbon nanotube, multi valved carbon nanotube, carbon nanomaterials of three dimensional what we are saying is a C60 fullerene. Now when we are discussing about C60 fullerene, the C60 fullerenes are combined with the alkali metals. I will tell you what is known to be alkali metal. Alkali metals are known to be that 1A group element, or they can combine with the 2A group element, alkaline earth metal. Then what will happen? When these fullerenes are combined with that 1A group element, their conductivity is increases. A low conductivity fullerene is converting into superconductor. I'm repeating, low conductivity fullerene is converting into the superconductors. So the main application of a C60 Buckminster fullerene is fullerenes are known to be that is superconductor, number one. Number two, I will tell you what is known to be that Buckminster fullerene inhibitor. Buckminster fullerene is nothing but a fullerene which containing excellent thermal resistant character. I'm repeating the point with which column when we are discussing about the fullerenes and the fullerenes containing excellent thermal resistant property. Okay, just like a carbon nanomaterial, when we are discussing about any category of carbon nanomaterial is containing very high thermal resistant character. Okay, I'm repeating. Next one, the strength of the CNT is up to idokka gurtinchukondi examination lo kanivachu. The strength of the CNT, the strength is nothing but a mechanical strength, right? Mechanical strength or tensile strength in vallu cheptunnanu. జనరల్ గా కార్బన్ నానో మెటీరియల్ స్ట్రెంత్ ఐడెంటిఫై చేసేటప్పుడు స్ట్రెంత్ క్యాలిక్యులేషన్ కి ఒక యూనిట్ ఉంది. ద స్ట్రెంత్ కెన్ బి ఐడెంటిఫైడ్ యూజింగ్ ఎ నానో ఇండెంటర్ యూనిట్. సమ్ రిపీటింగ్, వాట్ ఇస్ దట్? దట్ ఇస్ నోన్ టు బి దట్ నానో ఇండెంటర్ యూనిట్. నానో ఇండెంటర్ యూనిట్ విచ్ డిటర్మైన్స్ ద మెకానికల్ స్ట్రెంత్ ఆఫ్ కార్బన్ నానో మెటీరియల్, ద టెన్సైల్ స్ట్రెంత్ ఆఫ్ కార్బన్ నానో మెటీరియల్. టెన్సైల్ స్ట్రెంత్ అన్న మెకానికల్ స్ట్రెంత్ అన్న ఒకటేనండి, గుర్తుంచుకోండి. ఇట్ డిటర్మైన్స్ ద మెకానికల్ స్ట్రెంత్ ఆఫ్ కార్బన్ నానో మెటీరియల్, tensile strength of nanomaterial. When we are discussing about the tensile strength of CNTs, the CNTs containing the tensile strength is known to be that 48,000 nanoindenters. I'm repeating, 48,000 nanoindenters. Now we are seeing the question number 4 here. Cholesteric liquid crystals. When we are discussing cholesteric liquid crystals containing three-dimensional geometry. Liquid crystals of three main classification, liquid crystals of one dimensional, liquid crystals of a two dimensional, and the liquid crystals of three dimensional. What is the difference between the three cases? One dimensional, the best example is known to be the nematic. One dimensional liquid crystals are known to be nematic. The two dimensional liquid crystals are known to be the smatic, and three dimensional liquid crystals are known to be the cholesteric liquid crystal. I'm repeating, right? Now when we are discussing about the liquid crystallinity, the temperature at which liquid state contained in the solid state is known to be the liquid crystallinity. Now based on that liquid crystallinity, when we are discussing, one dimensional is known to be the nematic, two dimensional is known to be the smatic, and three dimensional is known to be the cholesteric liquid crystal. So cholesteric liquid crystal, when we are discussing, which containing a 3D geometry. Next let me see the next one. What is known to be a lamellar phase? Point gurtinchukonanu, lamellar phase last time manam cheppamandi, lamellar phase identified for pleiotropic liquid crystals. Right, pleiotropic liquid crystal best example entante sodium laurate containing a micelle formation. Right, now the sodium laurate is a best example for a solvent based liquid crystal. Solvent based liquid crystals are known to be that pleiotropic liquid crystal. Now when we are discussing about pleiotropic liquid crystal, the pleiotropic liquid crystal which containing a lamellar phase, I will tell you what is known to be lamellar phase. Lamellar phase is nothing but which containing head and the tail geometry. which containing a micelle formation, which containing soap like character. Next example, what is known to be the type 1 superconductors? We have already discussed what is known to be superconductor, right? Now when we are discussing about the superconductors of the two classification ani malli cheptunnanu meeku. When we are discussing about the superconductor, the first classification what we are saying is ideal superconductor. Number 2 is known to be non-ideal superconductor. Ideal superconductor is known to be the permanent superconductor. Non-ideal superconductor is known to be the temporary superconductor. Then now when we are discussing about that ideal superconductors, and these ideal superconductors are known to be permanent diamagnets. I'm repeating, superconductors containing Meissner effect, superconductor which can repel the magnetic field. The repulsion of magnetic field is known to be the Meissner effect. Meissner effect is permanent in the type 1 superconductor, and the Meissner effect is temporary in the type 2 superconductors. Type 1 superconductors, the best example I'm taking, yttrium barium oxide. I'm repeating, for the type 1 superconductors, we are taking a lanthanide oxides, a mixture of lanthanide oxides. When you are taking a lanthanide to lutetium, okay, these are known to be the block element. A block element lo series number 1 తీసుకున్నాను. Yttrium is known to be a part of lanthanum. Yttrium is combined with the barium and followed by the oxide. Yttrium barium oxide, YBaO3, is known to be the best example for type 1 superconductor. Type 1 superconductor is a permanent superconductor. Permanent superconductor which containing the strong diamagnetic property, okay, which is having a permanent diamagnetic property. The next classification we are discussing, green chemistry, is called dash chemistry. Oksar land which would istana jathaku chuddam. Green chemistry is known to be that eco friendly character. Green chemistry, green synthetic methods are used, green principles are used now, which preventing the environmental pollution. What is known to be that lyotropic liquid crystal? When we are discussing about lyotropic liquid crystal, liquid crystallinity is identified by the addition of a solvent. లిక్విడ్ క్రిస్టలానిటీ అనేది మనం యాక్చువల్లీ టూ బేసిస్లో చెప్తా ఉన్నాను. ద ఫస్ట్ కండిషన్ థర్మల్ కండిషన్. థర్మల్ కండిషన్ బేస్ చేసుకుని చెప్తే మనం ఏమంటామంటే థర్మోట్రోపిక్ లిక్విడ్ క్రిస్టల్ అంటున్నారు. లిక్విడ్ క్రిస్టలానిటీ ఇస్ ఐడెంటిఫైడ్ బేస్డ్ ఆన్ దట్ సాల్వెంట్ కండిషన్. బేస్డ్ ఆన్ ద సాల్వెంట్ కండిషన్ వీఆర్ ఎక్స్ప్లైనింగ్ ద లిక్విడ్ క్రిస్టలానిటీ. దే ఆర్ నోన్ టు బి దట్ సాల్వెంట్ బేస్డ్ లిక్విడ్ క్రిస్టల్, సాల్వెంట్ బేస్డ్ లిక్విడ్ క్రిస్టల్ అండ్ థర్మల్ బేస్డ్ లిక్విడ్ క్రిస్టల్. లయోట్రోపిక్ లిక్విడ్ క్రిస్టల్స్ ఆర్ నోన్ టు బి దట్ సాల్వెంట్ బేస్డ్ లిక్విడ్ క్రిస్టల్. లయోట్రోపిక్ లిక్విడ్ క్రిస్టల్కి బెస్ట్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఏంటంటే, వీఆర్ టేకింగ్ సోడియం లారేట్. సోడియం లారేట్ తీసుకొని, సోడియం లారేట్ అనేది కెమికల్ కాంపోజిషన్ అండి, విచ్ ఈస్ సిమిలర్ టు ద సోడియం స్టీరేట్. సోడియం స్టీరేట్ ఈస్ నోన్ టు బి సోప్ అండ్ సోడియం లారేట్ ఈస్ ఆల్సో నోన్ టు బి సోప్ కాంపోజిషన్. వెన్ ద సోడియం లారేట్ ఈస్ యాడెడ్ విత్ ద వాటర్, ద రెసిడ్యూ ఆఫ్ ఎ సోప్ కంటైనింగ్ లిక్విడ్ క్రిస్టలానిటీ. జస్ట్ లాగా మన సోప్ బాక్స్ వస్తున్నా చూస్తారా, మీరు జస్ట్ సోప్ బాక్స్ నుంచి సోప్ సెపరేట్ చేసి చెక్ చేయండి అయినా, ద సోప్ బాక్స్ కంటైనింగ్ సోప్ రెసిడ్యూ, ద సోప్ రెసిడ్యూ which containing liquid crystalline nature, which containing a semi solid nature. Lyotropic liquid crystals are known to be that solvent based liquid crystals. Solvent based liquid crystals containing lamellar phase. Next, at ordinary temperatures, metal conductivity jathaga chudandi. Last time nenu cheppanu graphical representation. The graphical representation we are discussing about the temperature followed by the resistivity. Resistivity is identified in the ohms inverse, right? Ohms. Conductance is identified in the ohms inverse. Now when we are finding the resistance value versus the temperature, when the temperature decreases the resistance value decreases. Now it is identified for the metal, but when we are identifying for the superconductors, when we are discussing about that superconductor, in superconducting state at a particular temperature, at a particular lower temperature, simple, When we are decreasing the temperature, the resistant value decreases, but a particular temperature, the resistivity value becomes zero. Resistivity value becomes zero. And the temperature, what we are saying is transition temperature. The temperature is known to be the critical temperature. But when we are comparing at the room temperature condition, the metal containing the higher conductivity when compared with superconductor. Superconductor containing the low conductivity when compared with the metal. So just I would like to extend the graph like this. This is superconductor and it is known to be the metal. Now when we are comparing the resistant value, the resistivity value any of superconducting material at the room temperature condition is high. At the room temperature condition is high, right? Then When the temperature decreases at the room temperature condition, metal containing high conductivity compare channel. Just I would like to compare with the metal to the superconductor. Jaat ko chudam. Mere metal ni superconductor to compare channel. At the room temperature condition lo compare chudam. Now when we are comparing at the room temperature condition, then what will happen? At the room temperature condition, the metal containing the high conductivity when compared with the superconductors. But at critical temperature condition, superconductors containing resistivity value is equals to zero. So superconductor containing very high conductivity when compared with that metallic conductor, because metal conductors containing resistivity value. Jaat ko chudandi. Metal conductors ki resistance value zero kadandi. Resistance value lower ga untundi. But critical temperature condition lo manam compare chesthe, when we are comparing at the critical temperature condition, the superconducting material where its resistivity value is equals to zero. The resistivity value is equals to zero. When any material which offers resistivity value is equals to zero, it is known to be superconductor, where the superconducting state, at the superconducting state, the power loss value is equals to zero. I'm repeating. The power loss value is equals to zero. So there is a comparison, Jatkarna, there is a comparison in between the superconductors to the metal conductors. Now, when we are compared with the superconductor with the metal conductor, then metal containing, you see here, the metal containing high conductivity at the room temperature and the metal containing the lower conductivity at the lower temperature. Metal containing the high conductivity at the room temperature and the metal containing the lower conductivity at transition temperature. So when we are discussing about superconducting state, just superconducting state of a discussion, when we are discussing about the superconducting state at ordinary temperature, at room temperature, the metal conductivity is comparatively higher when compared with the superconductor. Now, when the temperature decreases, then what will happen? Resistivity value decreases. When the resistivity value decreases, conductivity value increases. Just already points in our discussion, na malli meeku ayyo pyres unte nenu chestagalagandi problem athi em ledhu. Now you see here. Now let me discuss some of the objectives in the nanomaterials. A nanometer, when we are discussing nanomaterials, nanomaterials containing 1 nanometer is equals to 10^-9 meters. Then diameter of carbon nanomaterial, when you are discussing about diameter of carbon nanomaterial, is equals to 1.6. The size of nanoparticles is responsible for one of the following properties. Size mana discuss chesetappudu den base iskon cheptam ante, when the size increases, then the color increases, chemical reactivity increases, conductivity increases, and dispensability increases. Mostly we are saying as the dispensability property increases. Yes. Fullerenes from complex with one of the following. Generally mana fullerenes mana teeskunetappudu fullerene materials anedi dento react ayyatayante, zinc tho react avutayandi. The fullerenes react with that alkali metal, fullerenes react with that alkaline metal, and the fullerenes also react with that zinc. Point of sir meeku telichukondanu. Next, when we are discussing about carbon nanotubes are prepared by the following methods. Carbon nanotubes manu chusetappudu carbon nanotubes of two classification undi, carbon nanotubes of single valued carbon nanotube, carbon nanotubes of multi valued carbon nanotube. Now when we are discussing about carbon nanotubes are prepared by the three methods. Na manu cheppa last time quality good chesanandi. The first method what we are saying is arc discharge method. Number 2 is known to be the laser ablation method. Number 3 is known to be the chemical vapor deposition method. When we are discussing about the CNTs are prepared by the arc discharge method. Now we are discussing about question number 6. One of the following aromatic compound is used as a solvent for the fullerene. Fullerenes extract chesetappudu generally ga manu fullerenes prepare chestunnappudu extract chestanannu C60 fullerenes, planar fullerenes, two dimensional fullerenes. The fullerenes containing the different classification, from those mixture we are extracting C60 material. I'm repeating, we are extracting C60. When we are extracting C60 fullerenes, for the extraction of C60 fullerenes from the carbon nanomaterial, there is a process what we are saying is solvent extraction method. For the solvent extraction method, we would like to use a benzene. Benzene is known to be the an aromatic compound, right? Question number 7. The liquid crystals find extensive uses. Generally, the liquid crystals ekkada use chestaro man chuddam. Now, when we are discussing about the liquid crystal, the liquid crystals, they are used, they can have excellent electrical application, mechanical application, the physical application. Most of the cases, the liquid crystals are used in that LCD devices. Point gutinchukonanu. What is known to be that LCD? The word LCD is nothing but liquid crystal display materials. I'm repeating. What is known to be LCD? Liquid crystal display materials. Next. Question number 8. Green chemistry is known to be that sustainable chemistry. Green chemistry and sustainable chemistry entered. And it is known to be that advanced chemistry and developing chemistry. Point to touch. The materials that possess orientational order but no positional order. Generally, we have liquid crystals, we have three classifications. One dimensional is known to be the nematic. Two dimensional is known to be smatic. Three dimensional is known to be the cholesteric. Now, when we were discussing about this classification of liquid crystal, the liquid crystal, which is having no positional order, and which containing the orientational order, and those liquid crystal containing excellent physical state. I'm repeating, which containing excellent physical state, they're containing excellent solid nature. So, which containing the high solid nature, the high solid liquid crystals having no positional order, which containing only the orientational order. Question number 10. One of the following liquid crystal is used to both organic and inorganic composition. The liquid crystals like metallographic liquid crystals, either way, exceptional case only. Metallotropic liquid crystals are used in that organic and as well as inorganic compositions. Right. Let me see the continuation here. The next continuation, we are discussing about that solid state. See here. Their solids are isotopes. When we are discussing about isotopes having amorphous nature, right? When we are discussing about isotopes, the isotopes containing amorphous nature. Number 2. Magnesium aluminium oxide. Gutinchukonana. Solid state running. Magnesium aluminium oxide in jetta and spinal center. Ilanti bits me couple of distal. Next question number 3. The orbital contains a single valency electron. Single valency orbital atomic orbital entered. Next. Trivalence impurities are added to the semiconductor material. Last time on H2 now. Silicon and the germanium. Silicon is known to be the semiconductor material. Germanium is known to be the semiconductor material. To the silicon germanium, trivalent impurity, third group element impurity. When we are adding third group element impurity, it is known to be the p-type conductivity. When we are adding pentavalent impurity, mere trivalent impurity add chesthe dani p-type semiconductor materials antarandi. Then pentavalent is known to be the fifth group element. Trivalent is known to be the third group element. Simple. Silicon germanium ki third group element add cheyanana is a p-type conductivity. Fifth group element add cheyandi n-type conductivity. Question number 5. Now, when we are discussing about a zone refining is a purification method that is applicable for silicon and the germanium semiconductors. Zone refining ante em cheppandi? Zone refining where we are taking impure germanium rod. Impure germanium rod is converting into the pure germanium rod. Impure germanium rod is heated to high temperature. Impure germanium rod mana em chestam? High temperature heat chestam. Then what is happening there? At the higher temperature, impurities are in the molten state. I'm repeating. At the high temperature, the impurities are in the molten state, and the molten state impurities are easily separated. Molten state impurities are easily separated with the help of swiping process. What we are saying is a swiping process. Simple. Mere heating coil upayoginchandi. Heating coil basis kani impure semiconductor material heat cheyanana. The process what we are saying is a zone refining method. We are heating up to very high temperature. At very high temperature, impurities are in the molten state. Then when the impure semiconducting like say silicon and germanium, impure semiconductors like silicon germanium, which is heated to the high temperature, impure semiconductors, the impurities are separated at the molten state at the very high temperature. Just we are separating the impurities step by step. The process what we are saying is zone refining process. Question number 6. Then what is known to be the question number 6? Okay. And here liquid electrical insulators, they are known to be the Ascalus, right? The point of observation. Next. Magnetic and ferromagnetism uses. Next. An excited electron stays in the excited state for 10 power 20 seconds. जनरल मैं चूस ग्राउंड स्टेट एग्जाइटेड स्टेट ग्राउंड स्टेट इज नोन टू बी लेस स्टेबल एग्जाइटेड स्टेट इज नोन टू बी मोर स्टेबल व्हेन द इलेक्ट्रॉन इज एग्जाइटेड फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड स्टेट टू द एग्जाइटेड स्टेट द इलेक्ट्रॉन कैन होल्ड इन द एग्जाइटेड स्टेट अबाउट 10 पावर माइनस 20 सेकंड्स इलेक्ट्रॉन अने 10 पावर माइनस 20 सेकंड्स एग्जाइटेड स्टेट लो उंटुंदी पॉइंट गुर्तुंचुकोंडि नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 The term ferromagnetism. The term ferromagnetism is called for any material that exhibiting p-type magnetical property. Now, the p-type semiconductor material we can have the ferromagnetical property. Point with which one? We are discussing about p-type and n-type. The p-type material containing ferromagnetical character. Question number 10. Dash is a naturally occurring mineral that is a magnetical. Okay. Now we are discussing about natural occurring minerals that is a magnetical spontaneous materials some of that semiconductor materials having spontaneous nature they are naturally occurring which contain a magnetical property can we see some of the objectives here one of the following properties of metallic solids due to the kernels present in them metallic solids when explained this setup even you could have objectives mentioned what an object is right you see Now, luster is that one of the metallic property which containing kernels in the crystal side formation, right? Next one. Coordination number of the following crystals. Coordination number 8. Jat kuchh baat sir. Coordination number 8 unte dani BCC antar. Coordination number 6 unte FCC antar. Mali chepna. Coordination number 8 indicating the body centered cubic structure. Coordination number 6 indicating the face centered cubic structure. Question number 3 metals do not possess one of the following characteristics now when we were discussing about the metals having the following property but the metals are known to be very good conductor but it doesn't containing any of insulating capability metals containing luster character metal containing the malleability the metal containing the thermal conductivity but metal may not be an insulating material you see this next question The percentage of volume utilized in the FCC in jathka vindam face centered cubic geometry loni volume occupation value entante 74% point gurtunchukondi next question number 5 in fermi resonance gap what is going to be fermi resonance gap fermi resonance gap is identified based on that valency band theory basis manaku em cheptadante according to the valency band theory there are two types of band nanu Number one is known to be low energy band. Number two is known to be the high energy band. Low energy band is known to be the valency band. High energy band is known to be the conduction band. Now the energy gap identified in between valency band to the conduction band is known to be the Fermi energy gap. You see here, and the Fermi energy gap is a maximum in insulators. I'm repeating, Fermi energy gap is maximum in insulators, and the Fermi energy gap is zero in the conductor. I'm repeating. Okay, based on that valency band theory basis ka manaku three classifications undi. Based on that VBT, number one is known to be conductor, number two is known to be semiconductor, number three is known to be insulator. Conductor containing the energy gap value is equals to zero. What is energy gap identified here? Energy gap is nothing but the gap identified in between valency band to the conduction band. Okay, if the energy gap is a maximum, it is known to be insulator. If the energy gap is equals to zero, it is known to be the conductor. If the energy gap is a moderate, it is known to be semiconductor, right? So, if Fermi energy gap of metal is more, it becomes Fermi energy gap. Man increases on only a conductor can be converting into an insulator. Next, one of the following metal is a semiconductor. Iron is a conductor. Aluminium is a conductor. Zinc is a conductor. The best example for semiconductor is known to be silicon. I'm repeating. The best example for semiconductor is known to be silicon. Now explain its epitaxy is a process used in epitaxy is a process anadi that should be used in the doping the point gurtunchukondi next one of the is an example for solid electrical insulator best example introduction SF6 is a best example for solid electrical insulator question number 9 one of the following exhibiting ferromagnetism ferromagnetisms are known to be strong magnets and I am telling you when we are discussing about the magnetical property, magnetical properties of three main classification. Number one is known to be paramagnet. Number two is known to be the ferromagnet. Number three is known to be diamagnet. Paramagnets are known to be that they can attract towards the magnetical field. They are known to be the weak magnets. Ferromagnets, they can attract the magnetical field. They can attract strong the magnetical field. They are known to be the strong magnets. Diamagnets, what we are saying is they can repel the magnetical field. They are known to be the non-magnets. I'm repeating. Paramagnetism, ferromagnetism, diamagnetism. Now, when we are discussing about the paramagnetism, paramagnetism is the paramagnetical material attracted towards the magnetical field. Ferromagnetism, the best example, the most of the metals, what we are saying as ferromagnets. Metals like iron containing ferromagnetism, right? Now, the metals, they can strongly attract towards the magnetical field. You see this. When we are taking any of the metal or non-metal, when you're taking here on the metal, and here I'm applying magnetical field. Jack's children, magnetical field is applied just now. When I'm applying the magnetical field is applied as a B naught. When metal in magnetical field is placed, if the magnetical lines are passed through the metal, it is known to be a ferromagnet. Now, if the magnetical lines are strongly attracted by the metal, it is known to be ferromagnet. Then slightly attracted is known to be the paramagnet. If the magnetical fields are repelled, right? If the magnetical fields are repelled, magnetical lines are repelled by the material, and that material, what we are saying as diamagnets, simple ending. Diamagnets are non-magnets which can repel the magnetical field. Paramagnets attract the magnetical field. Ferromagnets, they can attract the magnetical field. So, here the question is like this. One of the following exhibit ferromagnetism. The following which exhibiting the ferromagnetism, what we are saying is a ferrite. Ferrite is a combination of iron. Iron containing the strong magnetical character. Okay. Now, iron is known to be a ferromagnetical material which can attract the magnetical field strongly. Let me see question number 10 here. The position occupied by a particle in a crystal lattice is called. See here. Generally, a particle in a crystal lattice, position explained children, that is known to be space lattice center. Now, when you are taking, it is known to be unit cell, right? It is known to be the unit cell. The small repeated units identified in the unit cell is known to be the small repeated units, what we are saying as a unit cell. Now it is identified in the x-axis, y-axis, and the z-axis. And those repeated units, they can have a specific geometry. They can have a three-dimensional specific geometry. And this three-dimensional specific geometry, what we have discussed is known to be that face-centered three-dimensional geometry or a body-centered three-dimensional geometry. A repeated small unit, what we are saying as a unit cell. And the unit cell arrangements are identified in the space lattice. So the position occupied a particle in a crystal lattice, what we are saying is known to be the space lattice. I'm repeating. In space lattice, the repeated units, which is having a regular geometry, the repeated units containing a regular geometry like FCC, like BCC, like orthorhombic, like monoclinic, like just like a three-dimensional solid substances containing different geometries. The geometries are explained based on that the arrangement of the particles in the three-dimensional space lattices. Okay. The occupation of the particle in a crystal lattice, what we are saying as a space lattice. It's all about unit number 3. Yes.